Let's have some fun modeling our blocks and learning a few tricks about blockbench. Hello everyone, this is Ali Reza. Welcome to the Mentor Code Lab. Before I start the intermediate course about block entities and dive into block entities, I want to give a little bit of pause to programming and have some fun modeling different things. Because if you recall, we have a game full of models, and right now, other than few blocks like that chunk loader or few tables there and the tesseract, others are just blocks. And honestly, normally when you are playing with Minecraft, most of the time you will try to stick to this block situation, because we have to get consistent with the rest of Minecraft world. In a flat world, doesn't matter how you look, and if you look fancy or blocky, things look nice. However, when it comes to something like a real gameplay, then being able to be consistent with the rest of the world is really important. However, there are few things that I would like to change. For example, I don't know, Ender Enchanter maybe, and maybe, just maybe, I think about the Tesseract. It's a very terrible model. And Solar Panel for sure. The Miner, I would think about changing this one, the model. And things like this basically need to be changed. Animal Feeder, for example, I'd like to have something that is more like half a block. These sort of modeling changes have to happen inside Blockbench. Let's close the game and let's start talking about Blockbench. Now, you can download Blockbench from the website, and we will talk about the interface of Blockbench in the next video. We will talk about modelings and have different model adventures, and I'm a terrible modeler, I'm telling you, but I will try my best. In this video, we will install Blockbench, and then we will talk about some plugins that we should have on top of the Blockbench. I will talk about each one of those plugins. So after downloading the application, let's install the Blockbench. So as you see, the very first step is to initialize the package. It will install it directly. It won't give you any option for the installation folder or things like that. I use the dark theme. That's the default one. I use the default key maps and language. However, we want to add some plugins on top before doing anything else. If we come into File, Plugins, we have different plugins that we can install. The first one is Minecraft Tile Generator. If you want to install it, just hit the plus button. The next one is cardinal. You know that in Minecraft we have north, east, west, and south, but in Blockbench we don't see those words. It's really handy to have them. We will install this plugin and it will draw N, W, S, and E around the block so that we know that this special direction is related to this special coordinate. The next one is fabric modded entity. If you want to have any mob or for some special block entities, don't worry, we will talk about block entities later, you may want to use modded entities. However, for block entities and blocks, it's not a necessity to use modded entities. There is simpler way that we will cover first, but when it comes to advanced rendering and multi-part models, this modded entity is a must-have. Then we have this voxel shape generator for fabric. This will let you have the bounding box for complex models. Honestly, if your model is simple, you should avoid this one, but if you have a very complex model, yes, having these voxel shapes help. Finally, you have a few more. One is optimized. Then we have simplify model. Then we have plaster. It fixes texture bleeding inside UV mapping. It's not related to Minecraft directly, but it's good to have. Then we have code view. Datagen export, that's for Forge. Don't install it. Also, if you look for Minecraft, you will see that you have these entity wizard, item wizard, block wizard. Don't install them. They are for Bedrock edition, not the Java edition. And these are the plugins that we should install. Now, if we want to add a model for our blocks, we have a few different options. If you want to add a model for your block or block entity or your item, the easy way is to use this Java block slash item. If you want advanced stuff, for example, like this tank here, or I don't know, the sawmill as a whole model, then you may want to use modded entity. From the next video forward, we will use Java block slash item until we get into very advanced stuff and we want to talk about multi-part models and fancy rendering things, because honestly, modded entities are a bit of work to import that model into Minecraft itself. So I will just hit this and I will say it's for Minecraft Java Edition, create new model, and let's give it a name. I don't know, test. In this project window, you give a file name here. Don't worry, you can change these later. Parent model is null. Ambient occlusion is turnable. Okay, keep it there. Default UV mode, perf, face UV, or box UV. These two are important. If you have a box model that will look the same, then you will use box UV. But most of the time, when you are using Blockbench, you are using fancy models, so you will have per face UV, and we will talk about UV maps later. Don't worry, we will dive into everything. However, I'm just covering this window right now. The texture size, normally you should use 16 by 16, but you will see that one or two special cases, I may increase this for a new texture for some faces because I want to have the ability to have more detailed textures. Try to stick to 16 by 16 as much as you can. Hit confirm and that's it. Basically now we are in Blockbench and these NEWS is that coordinate plugin. And this is Blockbench basically. You will have different sections and in the next video, we will come back and talk about these sections.
If you like these videos, please subscribe to the channel, hit the like button and turn on that bell so that when I publish a new video, you will get informed. Have fun everyone. Bye.